Sup, aku Arli. Welcome to another episode of Korek Physical. Kali ni kita kat tempat baru. Kita dekat Spanik Records dekat TTDI KL. And hari ni aku ada the owner and also an old friend, Nazar. Sup Nazar, sihat?
Alhamdulillah.
Okay. So, macam biasa, kita akan biar Nazar korek all the important releases dekat Spanik Records. And then, lepas tu kita akan sembang pasal music. And then, tengoklah apa lagi kita nak sembang. Maybe a bit nostalgic kan? Kita yes, banyak yes. Throwback benda-benda lama yes.
Tulis surat dulu-dulu kan?
So, ready?
Okay
let's
ready.
Do this.
Alright.
Okay, Izzah. Okay. Sejak sebelum aku selalu aku tanya apa baru. Tapi hari ni sejujur-jujur aku terganggu dengan banyak benda-benda yang macam menarik.
Okay.
Yang macam aku nampak Arista Birawa, aku nampak truck. So yeah, tak apa. Anyway, what's new? Apa yang terbaru dengan kau?
Aku baru habis dengan Pastel Light record featuring dalam single Melayu terbaru dia orang, Hello Sayang, something that different yang pernah saya buat. It's like more to city pop, electro pop. And then tengah sibuk untuk reunion OAG, the original Satellite Inc. Opera Radio Friendly punya line up in Kuching on October, and also the time punya new album. Nah, habiskan lah.
So yang OAG reunion tu macam mana boleh tercetus waktu?
Masa the times dengan OAG buat tempatan fest last year. So bila kita naik stage tu, so Sarawak punya macam ada government wak something like that tu. They ask us to getting back together because they want this line up lah, Mempati Putih apa akustatik punya tu, they want it. So they cari Alim, and then Alim cakap boleh cakap, but we need to practice. But and Radhi pun I baru met, he's like dia macam okay, he's baru divorce whatever, he's like macam kesian lah aku jumpa dia and I give him support. Yeah. But you must change. Macam when we meet during the Opera Radio Friendly reborn again, you got talent, why you waste it like this? Dia pun macam oh, he hug me. It's like dia punya semangat, Zah, kau buat tiga lagu kita terus rekod. You like apa? We tengok dulu how the reunion in Kuching. If you are good, we are good, we blend together, okay, we maybe do something, sing new single. It's like banyak yang kita orang patutnya buat after akustatik. There's a lot of plan. Actually, lagu-lagu dalam the time yang Soda Pop tu, banyak kan semua lagu untuk OAG. But banyak terbengkalai. So, I rasa sendiri pun, I have to finish apa yang sepatut kita buat after Satellite Inc. So, hopefully, this line up ada something in new year, next year ke, insyaallah.
Yang the times pula last album tu,
last album is last EP is like 2009,
yeah, Ballad of Jimmy Acid.
The Ballad of Jimmy Acid gonna be something different because line up baru pun is Bakri. You know Bakri is a good drummer, he's very everyone know him. But bila dia join the time, dia pun cakap wah aku can freely, sebab dia I know him, he's like Bakri, I want T-Rex, I want Slate. Dia tahu apa saja. It's like music, his knowledge dalam music tu macam wow, budak ni patutlah. He listen to all kind of music. Dia tak ada border. Cuma Bakri is like macam alhamdulillah aku dapat someone like him. Oh. So dia punya passion tu, dia datang rumah aku kan, tengok rekod, wow. And he's the bapak dia pun, dia buat band-band yang baik in the early 80s. Band-band macam Kingdom. Before, it's like proto-rock kapak in Malaysia, Kingdom dan band Terengganu yang reggae, the PBs. Everyone should listen to PBs. Nanti saya tunjuk PBs tu is like macam Malaysian reggae yang lagu pasal cerita pasal sambal belacan, buah-buahan.
Yeah.
Suka hati lantak dia kan, teh lambung. Very menarik. Dia tanya Jokit keep on asking me, I want that second album. Nazar, no, I don't have extra. Nak kena godek rumah si Bakri tu.
Okay. Alright. So sound dia macam mana yang The time baru
we more macam, hopefully aku kalau boleh, I want, tak nak stuck to the Soda Pop punya era. I want to something that more yang lain sikit. Aku nak experiment kali ni. I don't care whether it's sale or not. My fan pun dah, dah banyak dengar whatever sekarang. So I want to something yang lain sikit, yang more experiment aku rasa. Tak kisah mana tahu dia tiba-tiba time jadi macam Pink Floyd je. Something I don't care, I want to experiment. Tapi itulah, banyak yang cakap no, you have to do this, tak terkena. But when I experiment with Pastel Light, cakap oh, kau jinak sial dalam tu lah. Yeah, I want something that different. I want to be the reborn of me. I like lain. I want to be like open in any kind of music. That's it, because yalah, aku dah jual music, so I have to listen to all kind of music. I want to experiment all kind of music.
So macam kau banyak juga release reissue local-local stuff kan. Apa yang buat macam kau kau nak release, nak put out benda-benda ni?
Ali, we came from the same background. We doing zine in the 90s. Right?
Betul.
Kalau you tak ada passion masa tu, kau tak akan tulis surat, tak stamp value, letak gam, betul tak?
Taruh gam atas stamp.
Lepas tu basah.
Boleh basah.
So pakai boleh balik. Balik kan? Passion daripada situ, kau tak boleh buang sampai bila-bila. I hope I can, macam aku nak stop lah. Music tu pening lah. Tak berhenti-henti kan? But tak boleh stop. Seriously, sampai sekarang I'm 44 right now. So, bila tengok balik dulu, aku dapat banyak demo daripada seluruh Malaysia, Singapura, semua. It's like one circle of friend, you pun tahu kan. So you have banyak demo, even your bombshell lah.
Keluang bombshell.
Bombshell whatever, banyak. It's like bila balik rumah tengok macam-macam demo, even the Butterfingers first, masa belum diorang masuk major, OAG, Nice Stupid Playground sebelum diorang jadi pop, dibasah oleh Steve Tone. Dia used to be like very fast, Net Atomic Dustbin punya tu kan. It's like very raw. Bila Calibri sebelum tu memang diorang macam something right, macam different, Stereo Lab, lain. So we have like this C86 Sarawak punya. When I was in ITM, we doing this compilation called Just Eat This. Situ ada Nice Stupid Playground, Mr. Wilson Garden, ada my band, ini band Insane, In This Wild Child, banyak lagi dalam tu. So bila John Nice Stupid Playground tunjuk Zah ni, wah, aku dah hampir lupa. It's like orang semua ingat Meow City Attack. Meow City Attack is a later one. It's like Just This is like the first document of Sarawak punya indie pop. If in the 90s, Kucing
memang Singapore, indie pop.
Yeah, you pun know, right? Yes. Like, I have all semua demo tu. Because benda ni kalau tak ada orang yang document, bukan macam aku nak jadi someone nak buat benda tu, tapi it's my responsibility
to share balik
with the kids. So there's a lot of thing I have to macam document some of from my kampung to the kids sana. Tahulah about band-band yang lama. Sebelum kita orang punya scene indie kat sana pun, there's a lot of metal band, good metal band in Kuching, like Vomit, there's a good grindcore band, Sputum, Senseless, all this Ungodly Death, banyak di Kuching. So dia pun banyak yang ada berubah, ada dan dah jadi tabligh whatever. So I yang tak berubah lagi, I berubah tapi yalah, love for music masih lagi. So it's biar I buat lah.
Antara isu-isu yang kita boleh look forward apa?
Look forward is like Nice Stupid Playground demo, Just Eat This. I'm looking forward for In This Wild Child, Sarawak lah mostly. And then coming soon, Cassette Store Day is like OAG first demo.
Specifically,
like, yeah. Specifically, it's like important for the Malaysia punya indie alternative scene. It's like that one is like yang boom kan, right? Even me in Kuching, so aku ready is like my junior in St. Joseph. Mostly St. Joseph tu memang budak-budak Nice Stupid Playground semua kat sekolah tu. Jadi dia junior, dia budak lagi kan. It's like, oh, okay, budak ni buat panjang ke. Lepas tu dia transfer kat KL. Cepat-cepat balik, wow, jadi rockstar saya kat KL. Kita dah kat Kuching lagi kan. Dia stuck there. So it's like macam bila dengar demo dia bawa balik kan. Faruk Malin Spike. Dia so Kuching punya budak dia bawa kan. Tunjuk, wow, meletup saya macam budak ni suara, wah kan.
Cerita sikit pasal apa dulu-dulu. Dari start awal-awal dia.
Started dekat ITM lah. In 1993, after form 5, 1993. There I meet this guy from Kuala Terengganu. Faded Face, Smadi Faded Face. He's a friend of Joe Kid lah. I saw this guy wearing Kapari Terdang punya t-shirt lah. Tengok, wow, ni budak Sanjung ni. Panggil Pop. Kau ya, kan? Punk rock eh. Oh, Ramones lah kan. Of course, Kuala Terengganu memang Ramones dia punya tu lah. Masa Alan semua memang Ramones dia punya tu lah. So, cerita dia tunjuk aku Edis punya fanzine. From there, wow, I'm start interested. Oh, how this diorang, the circle friend in Semenanjung lah kan. In Sarawak ada fanzine tapi but we don't expose. Bila aku dengan Madi ni bila cerita, so I see lah the important of doing fanzine in Kuching. Kita ada band daripada macam area ini Valcha punya area, Tabuan kita, aku punya area macam, but kita orang tak ada nak export benda tu dekat Semenanjung. Tak tahu sangat lah, because mostly masa tu metal lah, metal punya fanzine is very big masa tu. So band alternative macam kita orang masa tu macam tak ada exposure sangat kan. So bila tahu Jokit is more like punk, is a different side of scene macam music kan. Oh, ni punk punya, kita buatlah something yang punk alternative. Okay, I come the idea buat jumpa budak-budak. Eh, aku nak interview lah band kau. Oh, okay, I will start contact flyers mana-mana. Ada flyers tu kutip apa. Just write whatever. I don't care. Tulis-tulis, hantar-hantar. Bila dapat balas, macam, wah, dapat flyer tunjuk budak-budak. Then, kita patut buat. Kau ada demo eh. Aku buat Buddy Holly Network boleh tak? Aku compile demo-demo, asking permission, sub-sub buat demo. Nanti orang tahulah band kau. Contact kau kan. So, dia orang beli kau punya demo juga. Di Kucing pun, kita pun boleh berkembang. Kita pun ada loss. Okay, okay. Skinhead band ada tiba-tiba band budak-budak punk. Eh, ini salah. Kau romper-stomper. Itu Nazi, bok. Cakap dia kan. Tak boleh. Ini macam. Aku cakap, wah, dia macam ni lah. Oh, ni hardcore. Eh, ni bukan hardcore ni lain. Hardcore ni macam inside. Ah, macam lain. Macam ni lah. Macam slide. Betapa daif dia kau punya sources of yang kau nak dengar kan. Because kau nak bagi kaset pun kadang tak release kat sini. Harap kawan-kawan yang dapat all this kaset with dub. Gila, tengah-tengah malam pun kau sanggup naik motor. Just nak dubbing this band hardcore punya, band punk punya. Band special ke apa. Wah, dapat balik. Kau dub balik dengan budak-budak kan. I living masa tu memang radang. Okay, kedai kaset ni tak ada jual. Wadab, stay special ke apa. Tak, four skin, whatever, apa. Okay, jual lah RM6. I dapat RM3-4. Okay, I will survive doing that thing sana. I'm too passionate in music. So, I cakap, I tak boleh ambil all this diploma in banking, whatever kan. Aku nak ambil diploma in music dekat Shah Alam. Sebab Kerawak, ITM Kerawak tak ada music diploma in music. So, okay, I plan ke sana. I go with my girlfriend in KL.
Ya, tu jumpa kau kat sini.
Yes.
Kau ada report. Besar aku ingat gitu.
Besar. I bring RM80. You know, dah bantu KLIA pun tak wujud lagi. Subang kan. The person who supposed to take me dekat Subang, Megat. Megat, mana kau kan? Wah, gua tak boleh terus JM, Zah. Kan? Kenapa? Wah, tak boleh. Tak boleh, you know lah.
Yelah.
Ketawa, ICAB je tu kan. So, I meet Fatul. Fatul bring me to Jokit. So, I stay dekat 121C dengan Shalan semua. So, they help me cari kerja, whatever. I just survive for the like 6 months. I go to gig, fire, whatever. Pick up, whatever. Bring this, the fanzine. Bring the cassette yang I dub kat rumah Shalan. Sampai rosak audio dia, sorry Shalan. I survive by jual cassette, demo, whatever during that time. Sampai dapat kerja and then from there I stabil sikit lah and I stay with Tang. Tang suruh aku duduk dengan dia. Yalah, masa tu saya dah main Fist of Fury dengan Farouk Malin Spike. Farouk kita, Kucing banyak sangat main indie lah, boring lah. Kita buat something yang insane ni. Insane main indie punk macam tu. Tak main keras sikit lah kan. Aku suka mencuba something baru. So we play macam conflict lah, keras, whatever, discharge, benda-benda yang macam panggil keras, anak kopang, you know, that time. Wow, this is like kau puasa best lah main. Selalu kau main so it change. We play that one. When we get review from Jokit, Face of Fury, so wow, we dapat invitation main dekat KL lah. Yes.
Pas Fist of Fury, kau terjebak ke Politin.
Politin.
Mana yang tak tahu, Politin antara band member dia, David Klesol.
Yeah, I know him Future Primitive lah. Dulu kan. Astan.
Astan Project AK, drama.
Yeah, Jibam, Status 103. Lepas tu Apek JB.
Politin kalau nak ikut first emo,
apa sah? Aku cakap emo lah. Because masa tu
sama kan Get Up Kids sama-sama.
Mostly memula you plan to doing a ride. Something like macam shoegaze. Tapi you know, Atan whatever. And then this friend, dia jebakkan all this mineral, all this Get Up Kids, all this macam alamak. Bila listen to Get Up Kids cover this new order things, dekat Cure dalam tu semua, macam oh, ini sama je kan. So it's just a music. So whatever people label this as emo, I still indie rock. Tapi masa tu it's like people cut emo, whatever, it's emo lah. And the first video clip is Edwin buat dekat Leaf kan, Emergency. Yes. And her.
So tu pernah release officially ke? Tak pernah kan?
Mana tu?
Korang punya demo tak pernah officially release kan?
Tak, kita jual. Aku print satu kononnya ikut tu dengan Rezuah. We have buat kabot dekat rumah, chop, sub. Pakai tu dah siap semua.
Maybe time untuk reshoot.
Have to ask tu. Aku tak simpan. Aku pun kena cari benda tu dan minta permission lah buat tu. It's a good documentation juga benda tu.
Kalau nak ikut betul-betul first band yang dari Kucing, indie band lah, indie ke alternative band yang meletup is OAG lah. Tapi OAG sebenarnya form kat sini kan?
Dia form kat sini.
Kalau ikut betul-betul Nice Stupid kan?
Nice Stupid background lah. Nice Stupid background, Indie's Wild Child, Adrian Tilbury. Yes. My band is like I'm from this band called dulu lah. It's what, Stupid Cupid Chaos, whatever lah, the record. And then we play with Insane. Insane agak tiga demo waktu pun aku pun tak, I don't know where the master semua. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, Alim dulu Nerd kan?
Alim Nerd, yes.
Nerd pernah release.
Nerd pernah release
EP
datang.
Eh?
Yes, because my mission datang ke KL juga. I want to help the band sana. Get recording in KL, dapat release secara CD semua. So I get, dapatlah all these skinhead band, Root Boys, ada Heroes, Nerd. Dapat, diorang dapat deal with Tang lah. So bila jumpa Tang, so from there people knows the Kuching punya scene. It's hard from us dekat sana. Dulu Kuching ke KL silap macam impossible, jauh rasanya.
Ni seluruh Asia ni.
Ya, seluruh Asia lah, agak jauh. So bila zaman tu diorang dapat, diorang VIP lah semua. Dia dapat opportunity.
Macam KL dulu kita ada Akustik, kita ada Victoria. Kalau kat Kuching ada tak kedai-kedai yang macam bawa masuk benda-benda ni?
Kat Kuching di kita ada satu tempat lah, Kuching Plaza. Everyone knows Kuching Plaza daripada zaman death metal, grindcore. Situ ada Rupert Ridge. So from there, sebab kita kat Kuching sana, Rupert Ridge ni memang dia advance. KKL belum ada Dato' Martin, dia ada. This is from 1985, 1984. He's bring all this imported t-shirt, all this Fred Perry, whatever. Banyak dia bawa barang-barang yang imported daripada luar. So baju band metal, baju juga indie semua. So situ macam pusat lah, pusat untuk budak-budak underground dekat sana kan. So daripada dekat Kuching Plaza tu ada tempat studio jamming. So every Saturday memang situ pack lah. Memang situ pack. Macam dekat sini, kalau di sini kau dengar kat Tama,
pertama wilayah
Amrah. Macam, ya, situlah. Kuching kat situlah, we share our kenal-kenal dengan musician jamming, share our cassette, whatever. Situlah tempat dia. Sayang dah kena roboh dah tempat tu. Tapi sekarang dia passion dia support budak skate dekat Kuching pun still on tu, William.
Ada lagi ya?
Masih lagi.
Kedai ada lagi?
Tapi dia pindah dekat Wisma Sato.
Wisma Sato.
Saya pun datang sekarang check. Kalau ada stok lama, saya tanya dia. Voivod lama ada lagi tak? T-shirt lama-lama ada lah. Tapi you kena check lah, reput dia apa kan. Black flag lama-lama ke whatever, ada. Mesti ada. Tapi kat rumah dia lah, check kan.
Betul nanti, macam mana kau boleh terjebak dengan apa, nak collect all the, especially the Malay punya LPs, EPs?
Okay, dulu kat rumah lama aku dekat dengan art Coffee Cancer Connect Match tu, aku ada, tu ada turntable kan. Bila aku pindah, aku dapat rumah masa yang OG rumah free je. Ambil lah semua. So you don't care masa tu. Dia after the time is like during hiatus, macam Alim dah balik Kuching, Mono dah balik Kuching, Mary. So I don't know what to do. I just, why aku nak beli turntable balik lah kan. So habis lah, beli turntable is like nak buat hobi balik, dah kumpul. Kau beli, tengok film Melayu, garaj, apa lama. Oh, menarik band ni, macam tengah balik rumah. Wow, bestnya. Masa tu aku banyak collect t-shirt. Tapi t-shirt aku rasa macam, dah pakai macam tu. Tapi tak tu tak dekat jiwa, tak puas aku rasa. Tapi by collecting all this macam benda-benda Melayu yang lama ni kan, macam, oh, there's something ni sih. Ya, pasal situ kau tak pergi, kau jumpa dengan orang tua, kau jumpa macam-macam lah. Something-something yang kau tak tahu terfikir. Use no F, you used to ride with Biramli, macam-macam. Orang tua-tua yang Singapura apa-apa kan, banyak kau jumpa. Mak Fauzi, macam-macam lah yang doing Biramli in MCOP Mall especially. So dia orang tanya aku, kau apa hal suka-suka dengan lagu yang Melayu lama-lama ni? Tak tahu lah kan. So it won't stop, I won't stop kan. Sampai Mamat yang punya apa dekat MCOP Mall tu, di sini kan, dia selalu main-main dengan aku kan. Zah, buy all lah. Come on, you buy every day. Your face. Yeah, bila dia tutup, aku betul-betul beli EP dia semua tu.
Keborong habis.
Aku borong habis tu. Sebab sekarang aku tak habis gigi kat rumah. Banyak barang-barang kita, macam tu, orang-orang yang archival daripada luar, daripada Europe, daripada Jepun, dia orang dah sapu awal juga. Aku cakap, oh, daun putih ni apa, dia cari Melayu kan. Rupanya dia orang doing macam yalah, dia orang compile, dia release. Jadi macam cari Southeast Asia punya music dekat, sebab kat sini banyak. Kita kalau compare to Singapore, we are cheapest. Kalau pergi kat Indonesia pun, pergi dekat Blok M, oh, mahal. We still cheapest lagi. So dia datang sini.
Kalau ada satu benda yang pasal muzik Malaysia dulu-dulu yang kau rasa ramai orang tak tahu, apa dia?
Orang cakap indie, first wave lagu Melayu, whatever, start in the 90s, zaman kita underground. No lah, 60s dia orang dah. Because label-label lama, macam kalau daripada, mostly daripada Johor, daripada semua, daripada tu, situ banyak kedai-kedai Cina yang jual, kedai runcit. Dia buka label.
Kedai runcit buka label lah.
sebab pasal tu boleh jual, tahu tak? Jadi artis ni dia macam Playboy record, Nifat record, Olympic, macam-macam. Jeffrey Dean semua apa-apa, banyak Eramli semua apa-apa. Dia orang used to be in indie label, right? Bila dia orang dah besar, all these Philips, EMI ambil dia orang. So first wave for indie tu 60s dah ada. So dia orang pun ada band-band yang rebel lah. Wah, yang buat suka hati, dia orang tak ikut whatever macam untuk radio apa kan. Suka hati fuzzy, yang bunyi crunchy dia heavy semua. Dah ada daripada dulu, dah ada. Tu yang Mat Salleh cari sekarang, because The Stooges ada 60-an, kita pun dah ada sound macam tu kan. Hip Pop Pop, Jimi Hendrix dekat Johor pun ada dah. Dia punya album EP tu, aku cakap, orang tu cakap itu dia haram, because dia punya T tu dia terbalik macam salib. Wah, zaman tu dah ada dah.
Rebel tu.
Benda macam tu yang buat aku lagi nak tahu pasal muzik-muzik lama kita ni. Silap macam dulu-dulu memang dah ada kan. Aku met Aso jumpa Uncle Anan Osman. Kalau cerita dengan dia satu hari memang tak habis. Because orang tu know macam mana awak naik dia punya Vespa nak pergi ke Singapura. Dia punya struggle, tapi dia punya passion tu orang lama dulu. Yes, dia macam siapa lagi ya, Rudin Alhaj. Oh, dia ni agak rebel sikit yang lagu Naik Keretaku. Kalau dia punya statement dalam belakang album dia, dia kan kutuk all this yang mainstream punya, Eramli punya. Dia cakap, aku baru balik daripada US, aku punya muzik lain sikit, ni real punya soul. Memang dia heavy sikit.
Dia punya sleeve.
Dia punya gambar kalau tengok pun macam pakai macam pedri macam tu. Macam orang tu ni, wow. Maybe aku dah lambat. Hopefully, I sempat interview all the musician lama, bukan di zaman kita. Kita nak tahu macam, wah, apa yang diorang buat. Macam Kasim Selamat pun tak sempat nak interview dia.
Dah meninggal.
Boleh
kita akan tanya Nazar, dia punya first album, dia punya first music crush. Macam-macam lah dia punya first. Okay? Okay, Zah.
Alright.
First album yang kau beli, album apa? Ingat?
This band called Cinema. Dia tak top sangat, tapi ada satu song dia, lagu Medusa Bukit Bintang. It's good lah.
Medusa Bukit Bintang eh?
Ya, tak jauh lagu dia orang best tu. Rock apa lah. Lepas tu aku beli Gersang lah. First masa aku terasa, you know. Siapa lain zaman tu, itulah yang
itu dulu. Yang first lah.
Yes, kalau orang putih lain lah.
Kalau orang putih?
Campur-campur lah, Tommy Page.
Tommy Page eh?
Yeah, you know that, rambut Tommy Page. Yeah,
semua orang rambut Tommy Page kau dulu.
Frost lah, zaman tu lah kan.
Album yang buat kau nak pick up instrument, nak main music?
Nirvana lah, Nevermind. Aku tak nak yang solo-solo macam rock apa. Susah, aku try duduk kampung lepak dengan anak polis kan. Eh. Orang solo-solo semua, alamak, tak boleh lah kan. Bila something dengar Nirvana, bila jam, forgot. Oh, kita form band kat sekolah dengan budak-budak. Mostly like yang skater selama-lama kat Kuching lah. Sopat, whatever, banyak cuman. So, it's like that my first band, skate punk. Nirvana, Sex Pistols lah, itulah yang keep me playing music lah.
First time kau dengar lagu yang macam, terus lekat. Yang buat kau fall in love dengan music first time.
Kalau kecil-kecil, my dad, dia banyak pasang this Kembara, Black Dog Bone, Carefree, and then Sweet Charities. There's lagu yang melekat sampai sekarang. Jangan tunggu lama-lama, nanti lama-lama. It's like my brother, kita orang memang dalam kereta memang kedengar lagu tu. Pak, nak lagu ni. It's like keep on playing, that's why it's Sweet Charity lah.
Album lokal yang bila kau dengar album ke demo yang kau dengar macam, ish, aku pun boleh buat macam ni kot.
Aku main band dulu lepas tu, OG.
Oji
because bila aku dapat demo, siut lah lagu dia ni. Nice. Ya tak, we love the simple three chord. You know, it's like macam the first crush of underground punya demo. That's why aku nak release the specifically demo tu. It's like macam, it's also impact me as a pick up the guitar, get the back jamming, tekan, sound, smelly, and everyone is like, that's it lah.
Kau punya first music crush?
Kylie Minogue. Dia dengan Jason Donovan kan. Lepas tu Martika kan.
Oh yes, you know, Martika. First time kau tahu yang music The Times ni ada a place in the scene yang macam orang boleh accept.
It's happened accidentally yo. Bila we got dengan Radhi ada macam, alamak, nak sign label, aku nak masuk EMI, nak kena sign whatever, nak stay 5 tahun. So how to do this? Nah? I don't want to sign, aku tak nak terikat. EMI pun keep pushing for the new album after Satellite Inc. So alam juga kita buat satu project band kan. So I don't expect it to be boleh didengar sampai bila-bila, but maybe because you do it. Dia sejarah dia macam ni. Kau tak pernah buat lagu Melayu. Memang kau macam, fuck lah. buat lagu.
Betul ya.
Mistik lah. You know, masa tu betapa tak coolnya kalau nyanyi Melayu kan. So, bila kau dah start buat lagu Melayu tu, passion kau lain. So, bila kau dah dapat touch buat lagu Melayu, that's it. Macam mission masa dengan OG, kita tak nak macam Rock Kapak punya style. Kita buat, kita tak nak macam Indonesia punya. Kita buat, this is made in Malaysia. Malaysia punya lirik. Kalau boleh, aku tak nak ada lirik kapan. Jadi kita gunakan bahasa Malaysia yang lain sikit. It's like macam, it's pure Malaysian punya things. That's it.
You were involved dengan OAG masa turnaround daripada OAG yang English ke OAG yang Melayu. Dia punya proses tu macam mana?
Opera I tak involved. Opera I involved masa tu repackage dan two new song untuk include repackage. Kak Andy yang buat dengan Radhi masa tu. So bila kau transition sikit, kau dengar dengan apa-apa yang kau punya influence, masukkan sikit something yang apa yang keluar dari mulut kau, and then kau kaji sikit. Ya, kau tak boleh tipu diri kau because you start listen from the all this sweet charity, Alicate, Kembara semua kan. Benda tu ada, aku dapat buat macam tu. It's like my acoustic. When I pass it to Paul Moss dengan Greg Anderson, wah, I want this one to be as a single. So something that you don't expect, kau buat macam benda tu, honest, yeah, keluar memang yeah, naturally kan. Sub, okay, jadi. And then I try to manipulate. Macam I, masa tu I suka dengar all this Swedish international noise conspiracy. Aku saja je letak konspirasi bising international. I buat dia lirik macam sekali padahal I just explain whether people will accept it, whether people tak boleh terima, I just do it.
Okay,
sayang, that's why sayang bila Satellite stop. We supposed to be banyak
faham
project on that time. We supposed to go to Indonesia, whatever. It's not much, be sayang. We opera ada market. I jumpa the cassette dekat Indonesia. It's like dia panggil sana Owagi. It's like macam we supposed to break the market in Indonesia. But yalah, sayang. Dia cakap tadi bila dia jumpa itu, I tell him after slow talk ni, there lots of thing that we tak habiskan lagi cakap. So insyaAllah if you okay, we teruskan sikit lah.
Since korang Sputnik, right, apa album Malaysia yang setakat ni orang paling mahal dia pernah bayar?
Kita forget about Piramli, of course memang mahal. Tapi yang macam unknown, macam cari kat hati, Titra is like Malay punya synth pop yang dia experiment this traditional Melayu with all this electronic stuff kan. Memang gila. Lepas tu now trend dia orang banyak tu funk and disco. Nuku Malasari, Flybait, itu semua value memang dah naik.
Bila kau cakap value naik tu berapa?
$150.
$150.
Because normal dia macam bila permintaan tu banyak, bila keluar macam compilation. Dia kebaikan bila Mak Saleh ni ambil kita punya, dia orang datang sini Selam, dia buat compilation kat sana tu. Bila compilation tu meletup, satu dunia cari.
Faham?
Tiba-tiba Fatimah Razak. You know Fatimah Razak is a good singer from Sarawak. Gila psychedelic funk. If you listen to the track Dahaga, Ahmad Nawab, maybe came to Ahmad Nawab. Ahmad Nawab is a genius after P. Ramli. Dulu aku tak, memang tak ada dengar Ahmad Nawab semua. Memang apa ni, pakai saxophone tu. I record punk. But when you dah mula discover the 70s, wow, this guy is macam wow, with the horn section dia semua. Genius. I complete dah.
Okay, untuk episod kali ni lain sikit. Selalunya kita akan suruh guest Corey and find all the albums yang important to their life. But since Nazar ni expert on Malay music,
not expert lah.
Expert. Yang aku tahu lah, yang aku kenal. Aku nak suruh dia Corey yang bawa keluar important Malaysian punya releases, album, EP yang korang patut check out. Okay, so aku excited ni Zah. Apa local releases yang patut di check out?
Kalau aku asal Sarawak, so I got some all this independent Sarawak punya release in the 60s, 70s. This one is like Christopher Kelly.
Dia sound macam ni?
Dia nyanyi bahasa Iban.
Sound dia macam ni?
Sound dia this fuzzy punya garage juga.
Oh, garage eh? Yes, walaupun garage. Cover dia macam ni?
Yes. Tengok baju dia, sakit habis tu.
Okay.
So Iban punya Anda aku sangka James Sammy. Kalau cakap sana orang dia mostly all this Iban. Nama dia corong putih sikit.
Nama band dia Nasib Teruna.
Yes. Kat belakang flat Sempoy. This is a very heavy one. And then another Sarawakian singer, this one is a very hot stuff lah. Fatimah Razak. This is a psychedelic funk.
Kalau band current, kalau orang nak refer, contoh?
It's not the normal funk yang macam kita dengar macam Syafaini yang disco punya. Dia dengan sitar semua. Sure. Very tripping. It's very hot track. This one go very high price.
Lagu Dahaga?
Dahaga, yes. you listen to it. Dalam pecah kilah dia. Before it change to Hindustan lah. Because in the 70s, banyak kita punya tu, bila influence Hindustan masuk, habis. Tapi masa ni, sedap.
Fatimah Razak Raga. Oh, meaning awal-awal dia orang start ni ke macam rebel sikit. Lepas tu bila Hindustan masuk, terus jadi...
Wah, bila influence Hindustan, you know, Sanggam, whatever tu.
Label punya kerja ni?
Yes. Dulu, that's why kalau jumpa lagu-lagu Melayu kan, satu lagu asli, satu lagu yang disco funk sikit, lagu Gusti Sentimental. You have to follow lah. So, this one is like, kau nak tengok Fauziah Nawi je. Baik punya. The Doors.
Lagu dia macam mana ni?
Lagu dia dia tak laju, is biasa-biasa lah.
Music oleh Colors and Tropical Strings. Yes.
This one, I love Helen Velu so much. This Uncle Adnan Osman punya ex-wife. She sing in Malaysia. She's macam Janis Joplin. It's very fast. Lagu dia best. Tapi satu lagu dia popular sampai sekarang, Kereta Lembu. This one very hard to find. This aku dengar this, she's a lecturer. Married to one of Selangor punya menteri lah rasa, Fatimah Ismail and The Quest. She's like the screaming punk singer from the 60s garage kan.
Serious?
Very nice, yes. Nothing but the heartache nyanyi, wow, best. Even anak dia pun contact me nak jual, tapi I rasa tak jual kot.
Oh, anak dia nak beli ya?
Yes. One of my favourite. Another boyan band selain The Swallows kan, The Fabian Boys from Singapore. It's very heavy, fuzzy, garage punya stuff. Kalau yang dengar Steam Kodok, mesti dia will know Mike Ibrahim, lagu Cok Cok Gendong. You know this guy, is Pelangi.
Pelangi siapa?
Ali.
Oh.
Ah, this original band.
Mike Ibrahim, dengan ya, bukan Dan eh. Dengan dia nak workers. Oh, dia Jong-Jong Inai tu. Dia jangan macam ni. Chong-Chong Nai. Ali muda-muda.
Sebelum dia masuk kembara eh. Wild muzik dia. Suka tidur eksperimen je. This one is Agogo 67.
Ini filem tu kan?
Filem, yes. Agak few situ. And then hari ni aku nak tunjuk all this Al-Fatihah to one of my favourite lah. Kasim Selamat and The Swallows. Yes. InsyaAllah, if I dapat right, aku nak buat compilation the best of him lah.
Ni complete discography?
Yeah, complete.
Complete
yeah, discography. Dia ada The Swallows and The Swallows Orchestra. Tapi Swallows Orchestra consider different. This is totally Kasim Selamat. Untuk soul jazz in the 60s, the sexy Judy Sudiro. She's marvelous. The first yang meletupkan all this pop yeah punya tu in the 60s is The Mods.
The ni atas cover hijau tu.
Cover hijau tu, yes.
Bila kau cakap dia orang yang first meletupkan tu, apa maksud kau?
You tahu masa zaman tu, sebelum orang kenal pop yeah tu kan, maybe kena bila, tapi tak ada local band yang betul-betul meletup keluar dekat radio semua, menjadi permintaan dia banyak. This,
The Mods yang first
lah. Yeah, The Mods first ada lagu Susanna. M. Osman was with The Mods. And then M. Said and The Last Remaja. Mua punya band, tak silap saya. Dan Dendang Muda-Mudi. Kalau Mak Saleh, dia memang nak sangat. Sebab dia bagi dia orang that the heaviest stuff from the 60s kan.
Serius lah?
Dengan bunyi noise gitar dia, sukati dia nak buat kan. Lepas tu, The Quest nyanyi lagu Melayu. Dia Singapore band. And of course, this Ramli and the Rhythm Boys. Masih kerap lah. After 60s, kita dah pergi masuk to early 70s kan. Sebelum muzik kita bukan dicemari di Hindustan, tetapi kita ada banyak band. Tahun 71, 72, 73 dalam compilation ni. Dia ada tiga. Kat situ ada satu. Juara Kugiran kan. Dalam ni kira banyak band-band yang daripada Ipoh, daripada Penang. Dia orang pun sekati dia buat lirik. Tapi this like macam very raw. Dia buat lagu sendiri, band Club Cincaluk dari Melaka. You dare nak buat lagu title tu kan?
Tajuk lagu Cincaluk dari Melaka.
Tapi seriously, dia main like macam this raw punya early 70s sound yang selepas garage band kan. Banyak progressive sikit. Dia banyak sound-sound macam tu. And the guitar masa tu, you lah, tahu lah sound. Aku terpikat sebab dengar dia punya composition, dia punya sound, dia punya tu, it's... Wow, you know from 1970 you tak ada apa zaman tu, tapi kau punya passion main style macam wah, The Burglars memang best. Les Vipers. Mesti dia tak top lah, tapi dengar macam
satu wow. Lagu ni penting lah.
Yes, kan? I know only The Rezas yang top. The Rezas memang
Tajuk lagu Kelapa Muda saya.
Yes.
Lancaku. The Westerlies.
Dah, this Westerlies dia pakai cowboy ah.
Eh?
Konon-kononnya macam Buffalo Springfield lah.
Power power.
And then
tajaan Brill Cream tu. So, oh dia RTM lah, RTM punya kontes.
Yes, yes. RTM punya kontes dulu.
Semua RTM
dia ada juara
tajaan Brill Cream.
Pun myself dulu kan. Ingat first English album tu zaman 90s berbuat budak semua full English album from Malaysian. Tapi you don't know this Blues Gang first album dia pun in English, full English. This is the best Blues Gang album. I love this.
Tahun berapa
dia?
Ah,
79. Zaman tu zaman disco. Zaman funk apa tapi dia orang come out with something that like, very rebellious macam wow. Elicat first album also in English. First full English album. This is also one's the favorite is Truck. One of the good Singapore Malaysian lah.
Singapore Malaysian.
Yeah, yeah. And not forget the Strollers. The Strollers is very good. Very dia kalau tahu it's like Innuendo punya bapa kan. Remy punya bapa dua dalam tu. This is like one of the thrash metal Melayu lah. If you remember Saxo, right?
Mm.
Saxo and you like this one Trust. This is the cover like Daft Punk tu. Macam the cover dia memang baik kan.
Ish.
Buat t-shirt pun ngam tu. And a recent favorite Ali this one lah from Kuala Terengganu before Musafir. This is like you know the Clash, Slade, dia main reggae punk tapi sings about burger Malaysia, durian, you know.
Kena lotri.
Yeah, yeah, kena lotri, sambal belacan. I got all this album dia. Kena ambil tu.
Mana?
Yang tu buah-buahan semua tu. Yang tarik botak.
Oh ni.
Yes. This is the band yang aku pun discover baru-baru juga under Titra label. It's from the my drummer Bakri punya bapak punya label. It's like this P the PBs this one. This is the cover dia. The three album the PBs. This one you guys should check. Memang it's like macam if turis tanya you want reggae Malaysia, okay, I show this but not for sale. Yeah, you know the Eddie song plucking dulu tu kan.
Mm-hmm.
Yang lagu jangan bunuh denggi selat kalau keluar dekat TV RTM.
Iklan RTM.
Lagu dia orang tu. Yes, aku pun baru tahu but it's good to discover them. Buah-buahan Malaysia. I wish you can song selat. Aku jujur lagi apa? Jeruk petai. Okey eh. Rokok, sambal belacan, pisang tak berbuah dua kali. Wow. My god. Tak payah fikir susah buat lirik.
Simple eh. tapi jahat eh.
Yes. Cover ni petai tu. Cover petai kat depan tu. That's it lah. Kalau cerita banyak tak habis lah Ali kan.
Betul.
Okay, last lah. This, aku baru jumpa itu kan. But one of Singaporean offer me. Tapi aku tak jual. This one from Melaka kan.
Melaka eh?
Melaka dia. Tapi sound dia agak heavy pop. Garage macam tu kan. Tapi vocalist dia daripada Bristol, England tu.
Oh, yeah.
The Valiants.
Too bad kita orang tak boleh masukkan muzik ni nanti copyright. So kalau kau nak marah, kau marah YouTube. I mean, I would love to like insert lagu-lagu tiap yang apa Nazar cakap ni but tak boleh. Kau nak kau discover sendiri lah. Ada lagi? Yang memang kau rasa orang patut cakap lah macam
This one kalau kau rasa Seni Sahuri dia ada satu band nama Suara Perindu. If you listen to her it's like listen to macam Supreme.
Oh yeah?
Yes.
Bukan a Supreme baju eh.
This one dengar macam for kita punya style lah tapi very good harmonize macam dengan saya macam Belle Sebastian. If you want to get influence memang sedap.
So let's say kalau kau cakap budak-budak budak-budak nak discover, kau rasa kita punya Malaysian punya album yang dulu-dulu cukup tak inspiration untuk band-band indie ni, you know, dig and then adopt and then like you know keluarkan balik?
Yeah, macam Indonesia ni budak-budak sekarang banyak dengar Indonesian punya band kan. Macam Muna lately kan. Actually, dia orang just go back to dia punya grandpa punya music, you know. It's like macam Rista Abirawan, AKA. Kita Malaysia pun ada. Just need a time to discover. InsyaAllah, if we do a compilation, it's more exposure about this unknown punya band from the 70s, 60s. We might be sound. Kita boleh compete dengan Indonesia punya sound. Because in the 60s, we are much far better than Indonesia. Sebab Indonesia kalau ikut dia orang zaman-zaman daerah Puspita apa-apa dia orang tak boleh main budaya kuning punya music. So dia dah banyak lari ke Malaysia.
Buat mana yang tak tahu Berai Kuning tu apa? Berai Kuning tu dia macam gejala-gejala, bukan gejala-gejala, benda-benda yang macam tak ada unsur-unsur
ketimuran
yeah, mengikut pandangan orang-orang berkuasa ke atas lah. Dia tak represent tu. Maksud dia contoh, dulu ada one point tu bila kau melepak Budaya Kuning.
Yes.
So kalau kau tengok kau bersosial-sosial lepas tu semua tu, anything yang western punya culture dia orang
western culture lah, western culture bagi orang dia tak senonoh bagi dia orang kan.
Dia cakap Budaya Kuning lah. Buat yang tak tahu lah kan,
dia membelakangi budaya ketimuran kita.
Kadang-kadang dia over sangat pun tak ada apa pun,
tak ada apa, dia cuba cuma yalah
political lah.
Yes. Jadi tak tu pun kita pandai juga kan. Kau sekat macam mana pun kau tahu pula macam mulut kan. Kita kat Malaysia kita banyak penjajah British kan. So barang-barang banyak, kita ni bebas, so we are more open in Singapore, in KL, so we are much far advanced than Indonesia in the 60s.
So, itu yang kau cakap apa, kita pun pernah ada Woodstock lah.
In early 70s kita pernah ada Woodstock 2 days di Cheras.
2 hari?
Yes, 2 hari.
Siapa perform?
With band like, aku dengar The Stray Dogs there. The Stray Dogs mostly yang banyak nyanyi macam Psychedelic Blues, all this that time lah. Zaman Arista Birawa, zaman Satana punya tu. There was there. Tapi I need to research and need some footage, gambar whatever. I have to meet more orang tua lagi kan. Yang retired hippie semua dulu-dulu.
Oh, retired hippies lah.
So, I love to meet borak dengan orang tua because kita tak ada ke zaman tu. We nak discover something that the, bukan the dark of Malaysian, tapi dia yang unknown punya, underground. Kita punya underground punya releases yang tak kisah nak tak nak pergi mainstream. Oh, that's one I want to discover.
Sebab kau ada banyak access ni, maybe kau patut buat buku kot. Kau buat buku simple macam 100 album Malaysia, Malaya yang penting.
Yes, tapi tak sampai lagi sebab aku geram. Sebab kita punya recording is start from 1913 or 16. Kalau kau dapat all those shellac 78 RPM, sebab aku dah dengar ada satu recording Melayu, dia orang cerita pasal kekejaman Hitler.
Yeah.
Kau bayangkan. Dia orang kutuk Hitler in the songs kan. Lepas tu ada a few macam lagu-lagu yang pelik, yang title macam Mabuk Ganja.
Serius?
Sampai sekarang pun orang tak berani nak buat lagu macam tu. Yes, if dapat the right thing, I want to take photo, insyaAllah I will buat maybe with you. Kita
ramai-ramai ya, kita
ramai
boleh
buat,
ya,
macam contribute satu buku 100 oh seri dua tip, banyak dia, banyak album.
Tak, aku rasa untuk start kau buat 100, sepatu nanti kalau dah jumpa expanded edition pula, reissue. Kita buat macam vinyl.
Sebab benda tu ya, that's itu benda untuk the document untuk future generation.
Betul.
Kalau tak benda ni habis.
Betul.
Masalah datang ambil sini memang sampai tak ada. Only a few collector yang still keep. I know lah a few yang betul-betul simpan semua kan. So it's a good idea.
Cuma kita buat crowdsourcing. Kita perlukan apa, designer.
Ha,
kita perlukan, let's make it reality. I mean it would be nice lah macam kalau kita boleh release buku ni.
Yes, tak boleh. No what? Even myself, kita pun tak tahu. PBs, kita dah ada band reggae, kita ada band psychedelic blues, kita ada semua tu. So cuma ada satu yang untuk dokumen distinct saya.
Jom kasi jadi. Yap, macam aku cakap tadi, korek fizikal episod kali ni dia pelik sikit sebab yang mengorek, bukan aku tak ada korek apa pun, yang selalunya guest yang beli. Tapi kali ni aku yang beli. So kali ni aku beli Gerhana punya 20th anniversary punya release, Mutiara. And then Arista Birawa, who this one. Aku tak ingat macam mana aku discover, tapi first time aku discover, aku was blown away. Ini macam Santana, Indonesia punya band. Gila babi.
Yeah, the best one.
Yeah. Yang ni sebab sentimental value. Bukan dia in the context like, macam mana tahu Steam Kodok. As a writer dulu aku pernah tulis an article, a feature pasal Steam Kodok. So aku contact mamak yang buat Steam Kodok punya compilation tu, daripada MJ Kumans. So MJ Kumans ni hook me up dengan masa tu October Cherries punya drama Habib. So Habib ni yang introduce aku kepada Truck, and aku dah lama cari. So yeah, ni korang kena check out juga. Dia macam Beatles eh,
psychedelic pop.
Psychedelic pop. Banyak lagu sedap. Surprise. Yeah. Broken Chance.
Oh. Suara macam Charles Nice Stupid bagi aku.
Kan. So yeah, aku akan beli 3 ni. Again Azhar, thank you for the time, thank you for the knowledge, and nak discount. Yeah.
Boleh, boleh, boleh. Okay, thanks.
Alright, till next episode. Ciao.